two clubs that existed before the Republic of Turkey itself, Galatasaray and Fenerbahce are old foes, and their respective fans create one of the most hostile environments that you'll find in the world of football. But looking at their shared history, there was a moment when they almost merged as one. Hard to believe considering the rivalry we know today. Hey there, I'm Adrian from Rabona TV, and welcome to yet another edition of Roots of the Rivalry. In this episode, we'll be looking at one of the most iconic derbies in football, Galatasaray and Fenerbahce. Of course, we have an entire series devoted to looking at the beginnings of rivalries between clubs like United and Liverpool, River Plate and Boca Juniors, Milan and Inter, and so much more. So, if you find yourself digging the content at any point, consider hitting that subscribe button to help the channel out. Now, a couple of things we have to keep in mind. We aren't going to chronicle the entire history of each team, that would take forever, nor will I be able to fit every single match they've shared together. I'll stick to the most memorable ones. Also, since we're looking at the foundational histories of both clubs and their supporters, remember that some things that were true in the past may not ring true today, but still drove the wedge between the clubs in their early years. Sound good? Okay guys, let's get to it. And I apologize in advance for my Turkish pronunciation. I got my friend Cem to help me out, but we'll see how this goes. Before we get into the history of the two clubs, it's important to know that the Republic of Turkey, or just Turkey as we know it today, didn't exist while these two clubs were founded in the early 1900s. The War of Independence, which started in 1919, led to the eventual abolishment of the Ottoman monarchy in 1922, or the Ottoman Sultanate, and the creation of the Republic of Turkey in 1923. Prior to this, the area where present-day Turkey is located was part of the much larger Ottoman Empire. And on top of this, as you may know already, Istanbul is divided by the Bosphorus Strait, which in turn serves as the continental boundary or border, if you will, between Asia and Europe. The eastern side is Asia, the western side is Europe. Though they are one country, of course. You'll want to keep that in mind for later. Alright? Let's talk Fenerbahce. There's some evidence that points towards Fenerbahce being founded in 1899, or at least the beginnings of it, but the Ottoman Empire frowned upon their people that played football due to the fact that it was seen as a representation of the British or an unwanted import. For this reason, football clubs had to keep a low profile in Istanbul, so the history books note 1907 as the official founding year of Fenerbahce. The three prominent founding members were Necip Okaner, Ayatollah Bay, and Ziya Songaren. Songaren was the first president of the club, Bay was the secretary general and ended up being the second president behind Songaren, and Okaner was the captain of the club. The club was founded and operated out of the neighborhood of Fenerbahce. Makes sense. Lending to the intercontinental aspect of this derby, the neighborhood of Fenerbahce is on what is now the eastern or Asian side of Istanbul. In fact, the neighborhood was named this because of a lighthouse that sat on the cape in the area, which was surrounded by flowers of white and yellow, daffodils, I believe, to be precise. The name Fener means lighthouse, while Bahçe means garden. Lighthouse garden is the literal translation. There you go, now you'll be thinking about lighthouses and flowers whenever you see Fenerbahçe. In 1908, a year after their founding, and with football growing in popularity in the city, a law was introduced that forced all football clubs to register with the government in order for them to operate legally. As for Fenerbahce's colors, well, their original team colors were in fact yellow and white, going with the theme of their locale. However, in 1910, Fener redesigned their badge and Songaren changed the club colors to the yellow and dark navy blue that is commonly associated with them today. Back to the football. As in the 1908-09 season, Fener joined the Istanbul Football League, which was founded by two Brits, James Lafontaine and Henry Piers, in 1904. In fact, this league was the first organized football league in the entire Ottoman Empire, and it was the football competition in the Empire and later Turkey for 55 years, until 1959. The original teams were made up of Brits mostly, though Fener's rival Galatasaray joined the league in the 1906-07 season, but we'll get to them later, don't worry. Fenerbahce didn't do so great in their first season, but would go on to win their first Istanbul Football League title in the 1911-12 campaign. This title would be their first of many in their 50 years in the league, though four seasons would either be abandoned or cancelled due to the Balkan Wars, the War of Independence, and the 1928 Summer Olympics. And this is actually a good place to pause on Fenerbahce and switch to Galatasaray's foundational history before we get to who's won more titles and why they don't really like each other. Galatasaray High School has been standing in the Bayolu district of Istanbul since 1481, making it the second oldest place of education in all of Turkey. The name Galatasaray literally translates to Galata Palace in English, and where that high school stands, which is a very prestigious school I should add, is of course on the western side of the Bosphorus Strait, being the European side of Istanbul. Galatasaray's football club was founded by Turkish students from the high school on October 30th, 1905, though this date is disputed by some. One of the driving forces behind the founding of the football club was Ali Sami Yen, or Ali Sami Fresheri, as he was born. Fun fact, he changed his surname to Yen later in life, and Yen is the Turkish word for win. Speaking of winning, Yen stated that the goal of Galatasaray was, quote, to play together like Englishmen, to have a color and a name, and to beat the other non-Turkish teams. Okay, so let's tackle their want for a color first. Their first club colors were white and red, matching that of the Turkish flag. But given that this was pre-Republic times, those colors weren't exactly welcomed by the empire. So, according to Gala's history, they changed to yellow and black in 1906. However, after taking a hard loss, they once again wanted to change their club colors in 1908, this time going with a dark cherry red and the yellowish orange they're known for today. As it says in Galatasaray's history, Ali Sami Yen, when discussing the choice of colors, said, quote, "We thought we were looking at the colors flickering and burning fire. We were picturing the yellow-red flames shining on our team and dreaming that it would take us to victories. Indeed, it did." End quote. And speaking of the Englishmen that they wanted to play like, in 1905, there weren't any other Turkish teams for Galatasaray to play, so they would play friendlies with the local English and Greek teams. They ended up joining the aforementioned Istanbul Football League for the 1907-08 season, finishing third in their first attempt, but going on to be champions in the three following seasons. The first time that Fenerbahce and Galatasaray ever met was on January 17th, 1909, over 110 years ago now, when Galatasaray defeated Fenerbahce by a score of 2-0. Fenerbahce couldn't get one over Galatasaray for a good few years. And when speaking of championships, not only is this a local derby, but it has the added spice of these two teams competing to be the best in Turkey. Of course, the Turkish Super League didn't begin until 1959, with Fenerbahce being the first ever champions of the Super League. However, as far as trophy count goes, Galatasaray has won the most with 21 titles to Fenerbahce's 19. The Turkish Cup, Galatasaray has the record there as well, with 15 titles to Fenerbahce's 6. I'm not one to take any interest in Super Cups, but for those that do, Galatasaray also holds the record for that competition with 15 to Fener's 9. Looking at the success of the two clubs, Galatasaray has had much of theirs in the more modern times, whereas Fenerbahce saw a lot of their success come earlier in their respective histories. In fact, Fenerbahce gained a lot of respect across Turkey for winning the first ever Turkish National Division in 1937, a competition that took the best teams from Istanbul, Ankara, and Izmir, different regions of Turkey, and pitted them up against each other. Why? Because prior to this, there was only regional leagues within the Republic. In fact, they won the Turkish National Division more than anyone else, a total of 6 times, while Beşiktaş won it 3 times and Galatasaray once. And the competition ceased to exist in 1950. As far as head-to-head results, as things stand on April 10th, 2019, only counting competitive matches, Fenerbahce has won 103 matches to Galatasaray's 81. And when speaking about European glory, it's funny coincidence that the team from the European side of Istanbul is the only Turkish team to win a European competition, of which Galatasaray was victorious over Arsene Wenger's Arsenal in the 2000 UEFA Cup final. They then won the Super Cup that following summer. In their early years, Fenerbahce and Galatasaray were willing to work together, with the two clubs' presidents even discussing a merge in 1912 in order to create a Turkish super team to take on the English and Greek teams in the Istanbul Football League. Ali Sami Yen and Galip Kluksazolu met and agreed that creating a super team, so to speak, would be in the best interests of the two clubs, in order for them to try to dominate the non-Turkish teams within the league. No longer would their clubs exist, they just have the one. They even had a name for the club, though it wasn't very inventive. Türk Kulübü, which translates to the Turkish club. However, with the Balkan Wars kicking off and thus putting a hold on the Istanbul Football League, the idea never came to fruition, and thankfully not, to be honest, as we would have been robbed of this great rivalry. But no matter how amazing it is, it has often been marred by violence both in the stands and outside of the stadiums. So much so that in 2011, away fans were banned from attending any of the Istanbul derbies. The ban of course pertained to the big three, Beşiktaş, Fenerbahçe, and Galatasaray. And despite the ban on away fans, tragedies like 2013's where a Fenerbahçe fan was stabbed to death by a Galatasaray supporter were not avoided. This ban was of course lifted in 2016. But the violence goes way back to 1934, where the two teams met in February of that year for a friendly. Keep that in mind, it was a friendly. Both teams wanted to win, however, as the rivalry between them was really starting to grow, and with tackles flying in all over the pitch, tension in the stands began to build as well, until there was complete pandemonium. There was fighting on the field between the players, in the stands between the fans, and the friendly match was abandoned. From there, every time Fener and Gala met, there were sure to be fireworks, both literally and figuratively, as the derbies are known for their outstanding pyrotechnics and intense atmospheres in the stands. That match in 1934 was a turning point in the relationship between the two clubs. Another flashpoint that drew the ire of Fenerbahce fans was, of course, the flag incident from the 1996 Turkish Cup final. During the season, Fenerbahce would eventually be the Super League champions, beating out Trabzonspor by 2 points. Galatasaray finished a full 16 points behind their rivals in the standings, and were expected to struggle in the final against Fenerbahce. However, they ended up winning the first leg at home 1-0, but in the second, Fenerbahce won at home 1-0, meaning extra time was needed in order for Fenerbahce to try to secure the cup double, or Galatasaray to get a bright spot in their season. In extra time, Dean Saunders scored for Galatasaray with what would be the eventual winner. After the final whistle blew, in Fenerbahce's own stadium, Galatasaray coach Graeme Souness grabbed a giant Galatasaray flag from the crowd and planted it into the center of the pitch. Knowing the reaction his actions would get, he promptly ran off the pitch and down the tunnel. This, of course, infuriated the Fenerbahce fans, who then had to watch Galatasaray lift the Turkish Cup, mind you, they did so behind riot shields before they themselves ran down the tunnel. Fenerbahce tried to have a flag-planting moment of their own in 1998, where a Fener ultra dubbed Rambo actually hid in the ad boards overnight in Galatasaray Stadium, and then right as the match kicked off, busted out, ran to the center of the pitch, planted a Fenerbahce flag, then stood menacingly over it with a knife. Insane. So to wrap this all up in a nice bow, what has led to what has become one of the most fierce rivalries in the game? How did it all start? And remember, what we go over here may not be true in the present day climate, but it is what divided the sets of fans in the past. Well, this one does indeed have a cultural and social divide. Not only is this a division of the Asian and European sides of Istanbul and the nuances and differences in culture there, but the inception of the two clubs is vastly different as well. With Galatasaray being born from a prestigious school, they became representative of the upper class within Istanbul, of the elite European culture within the Ottoman Empire in the early 1900s, whereas Fenerbahce's founders were from the Asian side, and more working class or middle class. The supporters of the two teams mirrored that of their founders to a certain degree. Again, at least in their formative years, where Galatasaray had the support of the upper class, Fenerbahce had the support of the common people, or the working class and middle class once again. Fenerbahce's support grew across the rest of Turkey at a faster rate than that of Galatasaray, at least initially, between the 30s and the 50s, due to Fenerbahce's aforementioned success in the Turkish National Division, the competition that pitted the best teams from Istanbul, Ankara, etc. While Fenerbahce's fortunes in the league have tailed off quite drastically since their last championship in 2014, they still have their home record versus Galatasaray to defend, in which they haven't lost to their rivals at home since 1999. But no matter the form of either team, even if the squad isn't up for it from a competitive point of view, the fans will always provide a spectacle, earning the title of one of the most explosive, passionate derbies in the world of football. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope that you learned something from this deep dive into the rivalry between Fenerbahce and Galatasaray. If you did, and you enjoyed the video, then a like is always appreciated. Also, if you're new and want more videos like this, then be sure to hit that subscribe button. Other than that, my name is Adrian, and I'll see you later. Take care.